You have a problem with Allah, every one of you. Think with me for a moment. Did you talk to Allah sometimes? You created a problem between you and Allah. Did you talk to him? Don't answer me. Think it over now with me, all of you. Say to yourself, what did I talk to Allah one time in my life that I created a problem between me and him? Don't answer me. Think with me. Or the second question, think of yourself. Did you do anything in life? First is talk. Second is action. Did you do anything in life that you created a problem between you and Allah? No. Did you think it over? Don't tell me. But I will share it with you. And many people come. Now, honest to God, if I ask this question to everybody, and what do you think immediately when I say you talk to Allah something, Brother Mujib, you'll think, what? Did I say something? I insulted Allah. Yes or no? Or I did not behave like what we said yesterday, the rules and regulation of dua, whatnot. Maybe I insulted Allah. I said, we have an Arabic proverb. Somebody was asking Allah, Ya Allah, he said, In lam taghfir ghasban taghfir. Ya Allah, if you don't forgive me, you are obliged by force. You have to. You have to forgive me. Is this the way to talk to Allah? You insult Allah. I'm not talking that language. I'm talking something else. That you, one day, you were sitting and praying and talking to Allah. You said something and you created a problem on the other side. You know the other side? Have you, now I'll answer the question and see how many of you say yes. Have you ever talked to Allah in a state of tadarru', nobility, humbleness? You cried and you brought tears on your face. Yes or no?
Yes.
Any time in life, not a single once, even once, that is your problem with Allah. Sure, what did I do to Allah? I said, because you loved him so much and he loved you so much, he said, khalas, that's your problem with me, my problem with you. Why problem? He said, I gave you A++ at that time and I want you to go to Jannah and I want you to be in Firdaus al-A'la. But every day Allah is look at your book. You are not crying every day. Do you cry every day out of devotion and love of Allah? No. So he said, either I will bring you out, back, or I put you in A'raf. You know A'raf?
Yeah.
Custody for hundreds of thousands of years. Neither hell nor Jannah in between. And chained down, crying. Or I want to keep you inside. No, I want to keep you in front. No, I want to keep you with Firdausi A'la. In order to go to Firdausi A'la, because once you cried in life and you got A++, Quran says, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. He said, I'm going to give you credit the rest of your life in the paradise with that A++ that you got it once in life. So what he will do for you? He will not leave you alone. He said, you are not crying every day. So I will tighten the screws a little bit to cry again. Make you a little problem here, little problem there, or sickness or otherwise, in order that you come back. And then I'll give you every time A++. Or, وَلَنَجْزِيَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. I'm coming to all this, one by one. So what I'm saying that, or in life, I said, you either said something, you created that problem, or you did something. Think of yourself. Haven't you done something in life? Either you put your hand in your pocket and you gave a needy Muslim somebody something, or you denied yourself for the sake of somebody else and you said, Ya Allah, I'm denying myself for those. You did not want to buy another dress, and you gave that money for another lady to buy a dress for Eid or anything. You denied yourself something, or you donated money for the masjid and you denied it, or you gave it to your mother-in-law, father-in-law overseas and to your relatives overseas and you said to your sweetheart, never mind for us, this time we'll make it next week. You did something good in life. That also you created problem between you and Allah. I'm using it wrongly but rightly. So when you are in touch with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, see what Allah says in page 98, number one, at the top, Surah Al-Ankabut. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم فلا يعلمن الله الذين صدقوا ولا يعلمن الكاذبين ألف لام ميم Do people, not only Muslims, people in general say I believe in Allah and Allah is going to leave you? No. He said because you said I believe in Allah, I love Allah. He said that's your problem. He said he has to test you. Test me? He said, yes, you have to go to Jannah. And he, therefore he said, I want to prove to you, he said, how honest you are when you say I'm a Muslim. He knows whether you are honest or not, but he wants to let you know yourself because you don't know yourself. You claim you know yourself, you don't know. He said, I will bring your soul, your nafs from inside on the surface so you find it. And he will put you into test to see how far you are going to be grateful to Allah. Or you break and you shout, and you say, Allah, why you did this for me? I'm praying five times for you, and you test me like that? What type of Allah you are? Khalas, you lost it. But if you find that he's testing you, you should be grateful. Say, shukran, ya Allah, you are testing me. I know what does, why you are testing me, because I love you. The other ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, yes, indeed, three times in one verb. Those who know Arabic, waw, waw al-qasam, lam ta'keed. Noon التأكيد المشددة three assurance in one verb see the ayah ولنبلونكم page 98 ولنبلونكم yes indeed the wow is vowing means making a qasam lam also lam you see ولَ it's indeed yes نبلون this noon double means double assurance. So three assurance, yes, we have to test you. Test me? He said, yes. Test you? Yes. What? بشيئين, just a little bit of khawf. What is khawf? Fear. Fear? Of what? You go at night at home, you are scared as if there is shaitan in your house, or you feel possessed, or gloomy, whatnot. So read Ayatul Kursi, nothing. Read Qul A'udhu Falaq, Qul A'udhu Binnas, nothing. But he's going to test you to see, to let you read Ayatul Kursi on a daily basis. He made you khawf, 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 khawf. He said, don't worry, because you are not reading Ayatul Kursi every day. You are not reading Qul A'udhu every night before you sleep. So I want you to have that type of fear in order to read it. And read Surah Yasin for this khawf, you get out of it. He gave you a prescription. In order to be close to him and read more and more, he said, because you said, I believe in you, so he wants you to read more Quran. He wants you to be close to him more. But we watch TV too much. We read magazine too much. Even department store, they send us all the newspaper and whatnot. We just look at them. We had one case in Chicago, husband, wife. God bless you. She felt very jealous of her husband when he looks at those newspapers that coming from department store. You know, he was opening and looking where? The underwear of the women's. She felt jealous. How could you dare you look there? So they came to us, to me and my wife, and they were fighting on that. His excuse to cover up, he said, honey, sweetheart, he tried to cover that. He said, I'm looking this to buy you some of them for you. She said, you don't need to look every day on these things because it will make you to go astray in the future. But here Allah is testing everybody. He said, I'm going to test every one of you who claims Muslim, mu'min, either khawf or ju'. Hunger. See how many Muslims are hungry in the world? And we don't feel with them because we are overloading ourselves with food. See how many Muslims in the Muslim world, they don't have meat once a month or once in a year. And here we want to make the qurbani here. Why to make it qurbani here? Give it to somebody else in India, Pakistan, Kashmir, Somalia, Indonesia, Malaysia, wherever, anywhere in the world. Let them feel happy, at least eat food, meat. Here we can eat meat every day. We have too much meat even. We are overloading ourselves with meat here on a daily basis. Don't eat meat daily. Eat it once or twice a week, not every day. You tell me once or twice? We can talk more about if you want in the well, about food, health, and behavior. Naqsa min al-amwal. You lost money. Allah loves you. He made you to have bankruptcy. Or a friend stole your money. Or run away with the money and you're without money. So you tell me why? I said, you, Allah loves you. But he made me to lose money. I'll tell you more in a minute or two to all of us. If you are not happy, he'll give you the other alternative. No. I'll tell you the other alternative if you are not happy with these things. Anfus, you lost your loving ones, either mother or father or brother, sister, or whoever. Person died from your family. All of us are dying, yes or no? Why, when you lose one of the member of the family, you lose all your iman and you start shouting, Ya Allah, well, how come you take me? Still young. Is there any young or old in death? No. A person can die anytime. If Allah chose me now, when I'm standing, I fall dead. That's his decision. I have no choice. You take care of my body, bury me here. Even if my family says no, bring me to California, say no. Islam says, here, no, then. But that's Islam. Like the story I told about Sulaiman alayhi salam and that companion of Sulaiman, he want to run away from Israel, send me to East India. It turned to be he has to be to die there and to be buried there. Thamarat, but he said, Wabashir sabirin. Sabr, sabr, sabr. If you have no sabr, lost hope in everything. Alladina ida asabatum musiba, qalu. What should you say at the time of crisis? If you say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, you get three credit from Allah at the same moment. Number one, ulaika alayhim salawatun min rabbihim wa rahma wa ulaika humul muhtadun. You know salawat, plural of salat. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala an-nabi. Yes or no? Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is receiving salat from Allah, means blessing. So you get plural of blessing by having patience and you say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So think of yourself, how many times you have been tested, anything and everything, even crazy Muslims shouted at you, yelled at you, or stole your money, or spread rumors against you, or you did the favor and then they accuse you because of the favor. Say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, you get salawat, rahmah from Allah and hidayah, guidance. Now, what's your problem with Allah? If you don't like your problem, He'll give you the other problem. What is the other problem? Let me. If you don't like this problem, Khalil, Omar, would you like to have the following problems? When you are doing family counseling, this is how you pacify a person. I know you don't like this problem. How about I'll give you the other problems? Are you educated? Yes. Did you go to university? Yes. Who told you to go to university? When you were a child, you went to elementary school and the exams were tough. But when you went to high school, they were tougher. You go to university, tougher and tougher. Why? Stay. Drop. High school, drop out. No, you want to be university graduate. Prestige of the degree, of the ilm, or money later on, wazifa. Is it not true, any time you go to a higher level, you have to study higher and blood and sweat and stay overnight? Of course. I slept on the floor for my master's degree at the American University in Beirut to finish my experiment 24 hours, drop. Here in Urbana-Champaign, I used to live on the couch for 4 years in the laboratory. Don't I sacrifice, you have? It's not easy. So you don't like it? Let me give you the other tests. Whatever test they are coming to you complaining, say, okay, I'll give you other test. You don't like this test, husband, wife fighting or whatnot. Do you have a father? They may say yes. Do you have a mother? Yes. Do you want now the news come to you from overseas that your father and mother dead? No. Do you like to have, you have children? Yes. Do you want now the news come to you that your children are dead? No. Do you want to have car accident, lose your legs? No. Do you want to have Alzheimer's disease? No. Do you have Parkinson's disease? No. Do you want to lose your eyes, sight? No. Do you want to lose your ear? Do you want to lose your... Do you want to lose all of them at one time? No. How about your father and mother and children and wife and everybody come to now and say all of them are dead? We have a case study in the old country. They were going from Beirut to Baalbek in a station wagon, upside down, burned into ash. The father tried to cut out, lost his hand. He looked at his wife and children and the baby, crying, the baby, daddy, daddy. But he lost his hand and blood is coming. He was seeing his own family, all of them are burning into ash, and the baby is crying at the same time. He could not help anybody. Do you like this to happen to you? No. Tayyip, you don't want anything. How about you lose your job, you lose your house, and you lose everybody, and you'll become homeless sitting at the corner and extending your hand. And you, sister, you like this? No. You, brother, you like this? No. You want to go to jail? No. You want anything? No. Everything I tell you? No. But you said yes for your exam in the high school and college and whatnot, and you graduated. How do you want to graduate? You don't want any problem, huh? You want to go to hell. You don't want to go to Jannah. You think Jannah is free? No. So what I should do? I said, don't you know there is something called sabr? You know what is sabr? Patience. I said, do you drive a car? Yes. Does the car have shock absorbance? Many of them tell me, I don't know. So how do you do? Really, they tell me, I don't know. Does it have, what is shock absorbent? I said, okay, do you know that when you drive a car, when you are bumpy street, up and down, then the car cools down? Oh. I said, if there is no shocks to absorb it, what will happen to you? You'll be dancing in the car and hitting your head and the ceiling. Oh, I didn't know that. I said, yes. So you know why those excellent engineers have put those shock absorbers? So you don't have bumping up and down. Why you are bumping up and down? Why don't you have shock absorbance and then cool yourself down? How can I cool myself? I said, you have to cool yourself and have shock absorber. How can I have shock absorbance myself? I said, number one, you have to have sabr. And Allah says it, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اصْبِرُوا وَصَابِرُوا. What? Sabiru is not enough sabr. When your sabr has lost, you reach the maximum of the sabr, now you have to buy another sabr called musabara. Now I said, suppose you are driving Fiat or Volkswagen. It has shock absorbance, itsy bitsy. But Mercedes has bigger, and Cadillac, whatever. So why don't you go and get a bigger shock absorbance, replace it, and get to keep the car working? So in order to live peacefully, when your sabr is lost, you have to go and improve by getting better sabr, which is called musabr. Isbiru sabiru. Have more sabr on the lost sabr. But for how long? This problem is going to face me. One day, 1 year, 10 years? Well, I don't know. It depends between relationship with Allah. He said, warabitu. Rabitu, never ever lose hope. Continue with this sabr and musabara till you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't want? I can't help you. And then you will never have sabr and musabara and murabata unless you have number four. Wattaqullah, taqwa. When you have taqwa, then Allah will send you angels from heaven to show you how to have sabr with musabara and with continuity till the end, till you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, we tell them that this life is a life of testing and there is no way that you will get out of it. So your problem is, when you have any problem, what to do? At page 101.